Let's go to the book of Hebrews 13, verse 8.
My Bible is there.
Hebrews 13, verse 8. Just verse 8 only. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday and today and forever. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forever. People of God, don't ever look at yourself and feel that you are not qualified to receive from God. No matter what is happening around you, happening in your foundation, in your family, in your career, don't ever see yourself as one who is not qualified to receive from God. As long as you were created by God, God has planned for your life that must surely come to pass. Every child of God must learn to have faith in God for the unusual. Until our faith grow in God, we can receive from God. What Jesus did yesterday, he can do today, he can do tomorrow. And that is why today I'm here to remind you that with God, all things are possible. Right from the first day of this program, we had a powerful word of God, the second day, the third day. And today, God is telling you that what he did yesterday, he can do today, he can do even tomorrow. Somebody shout hallelujah. Sometimes back, a lecturer in Uniben, he was having challenges. He said a no lecturer, but he was stagnated. He was in one position for years. So somebody introduced the wife to this ministry, and the man followed. They came. In fact, he's a philosopher. That's what he teaches, philosopher. So they came and I canceled him. But initially, I wonder, how do I talk to this man? Because these people don't always believe God or the word of God. But with the help of the Holy Spirit, I canceled him. He began to come to the church. You hear me, everyone? All these doctors, lecturers, there is something they publish on net. When any country that picked them up, they said they give them a scholarship, they pick them up and help them up. He has been doing his own. Even those he taught, those one has gone. Those one were picked up. But his own for years. People across the country will always make good accommodation of his own, but nobody ever picked him. I prayed for him, prayed for him, prayed for him, placed him on program. He followed up. Hear me, ladies and gentlemen. Shortly, they picked him up. They picked him up in England. He went to England. He did very well. And after everything, his project, as a project he wrote, he put my name there. If not Pastor Pia Obaseki, I will not be where I am today. But listen, before he was picked up, there was signs that his real problem is from those he is taking care of in his family. But I told him, don't fight the battle by your strength. Just keep on a prayer. God has a way of fighting battles. And God fought the battle. God brought him out of the thorns and thistles. And God gave him a new song. And God placed him in the position he was destined to be in life. Initially, he will always ask me questions. Pastor, are you sure God can really do this thing? Are you sure he's going to work? He asked a lot of questions based on what the books he has read. Me standing before him, who is not educated, I will also answer him for the scripture. But at the end, God glorified himself as the God of yesterday, today, and forever. Everyone here, God will glorify himself in your situation as the God of yesterday, today, and forever in the name of Jesus. A woman gave birth to her baby through operation. And when the service here, I was led by God to prophesy to the woman. She was pregnant again. I said to her, the Lord said, you are going to give birth yourself, not with operation anymore. I think she's in service today here. After the meeting, I think a few days later, she fell into labor. She gave birth by herself without operation. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. Ladies and gentlemen, a sister was picked up from Europe to be deported to Nigeria. They have concluded. Our own sister in this church sent her my phone number before time where there was no trial. But she never called me one day. When she was picked up to deportation camp, she didn't call. When they led her to the plane, all the Nigerians to be deported, all of them were inside the plane. They had given her a ticket. She sat down inside the plane. She remembered that her sister sent her Pastor P.I.A. Obaseki's phone number. She brought out her phone inside the plane while the plane was warming up to move. She brought out her diary. She searched for my number and she called my number. I answered her. She explained to me and I said to her, worry not, you are not going to be deported. From now, you are discharged and acquitted. It was not up to 5 minutes. Two policemen entered the aircraft. And as they entered, they were looking as if we were looking for somebody, looking up at her. When they came to her seat, they asked her, what are you doing here? She said, I'm under deportation. Then the air hostess came. What's the matter? They asked them, this lady is not supposed to be here. Why is she here? That one said, no. The police, they put in the plane to escort them to Nigeria. Those one and this one that came in, they began to argue. And the one that came in said, no, she is going down for this flight. And they took her down for the flight. Ladies and gentlemen, they took her out of the flight. Come on. Her seat was vacant to Nigeria. Every seat the enemy place you to dethrone you and frustrate you. From now, I remove you from that seat in the name of Jesus. Amen. Hear me, everyone. Every seat the enemy place you. Over many years now, you have been on that seat. You have been telling stories. You have been on that seat. You have to be difficult with you. You have been on that seat. You have never been somebody. Hear me? You have been on that seat under manipulation. When the enemy come again to try to locate you in that seat this year, they will not see you in that seat anymore. Amen. They will not see you in that seat anymore. Amen. They will not see you in that seat anymore. Amen. They will not see you in that seat anymore. Amen. They will not see you in that seat anymore. Amen. They will not see you in that seat anymore. Amen. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. The seat were vacant to Nigeria. They brought that out of the plane and they took her to the office. Hear me? And they asked her to fill some forms. She filled the form. For a few days later, they call her. They gave her 5 years resident permit. Are you not aware of the testimony here? You have seen it. I am not trying to entertain you. It is real. She came from Italy to come and share the testimony here and went back to Italy. Hear me, everyone. Everywhere the enemy have deposed you, wherever they depose you, from now, I am bringing you out of there in the name of Jesus. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forever. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hear me, everyone. What God have done for others, that same God can do for you. Amen. What God have done for Peter, that same God can do for you. Amen. What God did for Sarah, that same God can do for you. Amen. What God did for Anna, that same God can do for you. Amen. Somebody shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hear me, everyone. When the governorship election were going on, the Lord revealed to me, look at the person that's going to win the election. I didn't tell anybody. All I did, I went ahead, I called my printer. I said, produce photo frame for me. You know what? Photo frame. Put the man's name, social name, governor. I said, put Godwin Obasek. I'm not a politician, no, but what God revealed to me. Why am I talking about this? There are people here God is going to exalt after
Amen.
Now.
Amen.
If you come to my office right from May last year, you will see the photo frame in my office, in all my offices. I said, this is the person that is going to win the election, no matter what happened. That is what God has said. I don't know the man. I know nobody, but I knew God. I heard from God. I may not make noise on news or on newspaper, but what God said to me, I put it on frame so that everyone will see it. I put the photo frame while I was doing the frame. Those who were doing it, they were laughing at me. They were laughing at Obaseki. They said, because it's his brother. Not because I don't know him. But ladies and gentlemen, when the set time came, the word of God came to pass.
Yes,
I prophesied upon your life. This is your set time. 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 Beginning from now, the level you are now, receive grace for graduation. Receive grace for graduation.
Amen.
Receive grace for graduation.
Amen.
Somebody shout a louder amen 7 times.
Amen.
2.
Amen.
3.
Amen.
4.
Amen.
5.
Amen.
6.
Amen.
7.
Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are the evidence. You saw the sister that the husband abandoned here. The husband said, I am no more interested in you. The husband went and did introduction with another lady. Ladies and gentlemen, God settled the matter. The man came back and begged the wife, and the marriage settled back. Whatever that we have scattered in your life, whatever that we have scattered in your life, beginning from now,
yes, sir,
begin to receive settlement by grace.
Hey.
No life is so scattered that God cannot restore.
Yes,
no disorganization that God cannot rearrange.
Yes,
whatever that is shattered in your life, whatever that is disorganized in your life, whatever that is confused in your life, whatever the enemy has tampered in your life,
yes,
I hear the word of God. Jesus Christ the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. Beginning from now,
yes,
you will experience the power of God in your matter. You will see the power of God in your matter.
Amen.
You will see the power of God in your matter.
Amen.
You will see the power of God in your matter.
Amen.
Somebody give me a turn around. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I know that the word of God will never go unfulfilled. God says, who is he that says, when the Lord has not commanded? He said, every word that goes out of my mouth, it shall never go unfulfilled.
Yes,
it shall accomplish that which I send it for.
Uh-huh.
There is a word of God for your life. There is a word of God for your marriage. There is a word of God for your career. There is a word of God for your destiny. There is a word of God for your family. There is a word of God for your business. There is a word of God for your health. Beginning from now, every word the mouth of God has spoken concerning your issue, concerning your matter, beginning from now,
yes,
it shall come to pass.
Amen.
Beginning from now, it shall come to pass.
Amen.
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 Somebody shout a 7 loud amen.
Amen.
Two.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Were you not here yesterday about a sister that suffered allegation, that suffered opposition, that suffered neglect, that suffered a abandonment, that you can never get married. They gave her all sorts of names. You were yesterday when she testified that the day of her testimony, a brand new Camry car were used to wipe away her tears. Hey. That those who were condemning her before, they came and began to eat under canopy. This made me to know that we are not serving a dead God. We serve a living God.
Yes, sir.
I prophesy over your life.
I receive.
Beginning from now, every confused issue in your life,
yes, sir,
my God shall give you a divine introduction.
Amen.
Hear me, everyone. In that office where you work, in that online where you do your business, beginning from now, you shall be the greatest in that life.
Amen.
I speak over your life.
I receive.
Every area your life has looked awkward.
Hey.
Beginning from now,
yes,
every area you have not been seeing the glory of God. Every area you are not organized.
Yes.
Every area you are not prospering.
Uh-huh.
I decree that yoke is broken in your life.
Amen.
Have you not seen the sister that testified, the Margaret TV partner, in a place of work at a knot? That she there, so that a place where she was even small there, when their boss came, they picked her from the list and made her the head of the place. What are you talking about? I am the God of all flesh. Is there anything too hard for me to do?
No.
I am telling you, don't look down on yourself.
Yes, sir.
Don't look down on yourself.
Yes, sir.
You are going somewhere.
Yes, sir.
You are too loaded to be down.
Uh-huh.
You are too loaded to be frustrated.
Amen.
You are too loaded to be abandoned.
Amen.
You are too loaded to be neglected.
Amen.
There is something in you that the world will look for.
Amen.
That sin I've been covered before.
Amen.
But God has sent me to uncover you now.
Amen.
Because beginning from now, you shall be a solution to your generation.
Amen.
I say beginning from now,
uh-huh,
you shall be a solution to your generation.
Amen.
You shall be a solution to your generation.
Amen.
You shall be a solution to your generation.
Amen.
My God shall be your God.
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 Amen.
Somebody shout it loud, amen, several times.
Amen.
Two.
Amen.
Three.
Amen.
Four.
Amen.
Five.
Amen.
Six.
Amen.
Seven.
Amen.
Listen, a young brother came from Spain. When he came to Nigeria, after all the things he came to do, after settling the families, he wanted to go back to Spain. When he got to Lagos, they said, this your resident permit is not your own. This is impersonation. This is not you. You are faking it. Ladies and gentlemen, they brought him back. He came to Benin. He do again. He planned to go again. They hold him in Spain. They said, this is not your document. It's fake. They deported him back to Nigeria. The friend brought him to the church. He came to the prayer line, and I prayed for him. He was delivered. He went. He got a victory oil. He went back to Spain as he moved from Nigeria, express down to Spain.
Yes,
hear me, ladies and gentlemen. All those conquerors, all those demonic powers that have been stopping your express journey to destiny, all those father's house enemies, all those mother's house enemies, all those enemies in your working place, all those enemies in the company you see that are disturbing your express journey to destiny, beginning from now,
yes,
their efforts are frustrated in your life.
Hey.
Hear me? Anyone that sit on your promotion this year, you shall attend their obituary.
Amen.
Either in your place of work, in your place of work, in your place of business, anyone that sits on your promotion, sits on what belongs to you, sits on your progress, sits on your breakthrough, sits on your success, sits on your greatness, you shall attend their obituary.
Amen.
Jesus says, those my enemies who will not want me to reign over them, bring them hither and let me lay my feet on their head. Hear me, everyone, under this grace and the God of solution.
whatever miserableness, whatever frustration you have experienced in life before coming to the God of solution, beginning from now, testimony is taking place in your life. Hear me, wherever you are, whatever that we're wrong with your destiny, whatever that we're wrong with your career, whatever that we're wrong with your life, whatever that we're wrong with your marriage, whatever that we're wrong with your finance, beginning from now, receive divine correction.
Amen.
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 Somebody shout, I receive several times.
I receive.
Two.
I receive.
Three.
I receive.
Four.
I receive.
Five.
I receive.
Six.
I receive.
Seven.
I receive.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about? This is the word of God. Jesus Christ, the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. I have this word from God to you, that this year, there is no witches and wizard that will be able to pin you down in one position.
Amen.
I have this word of God for you. 2017, there is no evil power that can pin you down in the same position.
Amen.
You are a child of God. The child of the Most High.
Yes,
the child of Alpha.
Yes,
the child of Omega.
Uh-huh.
The child of Jehovah Nissi.
Yes,
the child of the Lion of the tribe of Judah.
Yes,
the child of Jehovah Roy.
Uh-huh.
The child of Jehovah Rufeka.
Uh-huh.
The child of Jehovah Engedi.
Amen.
The child of Jehovah Rufeka.
Amen.
The child of Jehovah Elohim.
Amen.
The child of Jehovah Nsindeko.
Amen.
Beginning from now, every wicked hand that shall temper with your issue, temper with your children's issue, temper with your marriage issue, temper with your issue this year, they shall be withered.
Amen.
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 Somebody shout, I believe several times.
I believe.
Two.
I believe.
Three.
I believe.
Four.
I believe.
Five.
I believe.
Six.
I believe.
Seven.
I believe.
Hear me. I don't believe in witches and wizards destroy somebody's life and at the end they begin to confess. No! I know so many of you, they like to hear confession. When they begin to confess, like, there's one of my friends, we were together in Ibadan. He was working in the company where they produce this plastic chair. When he was on leave, he traveled to the village at Uromi. When he got there, he bought rapa, shared rapa to all. The father have about 6 wives. Shared rapa for all of them, gave all of their clothes, gave them money to sew the clothes, and give them wine and silver fancy. They celebrated with the friends. Hear me, ladies and gentlemen. The father's mother, who is an old woman, this man gave him rapa. He forgot to give that old woman money to sew the rapa. When he went back to Ibadan, when he went back to resume work, that very week, the conveyor belt, there's one belt that used to move for the engine that produced this white chair. The conveyor belt carried his overall. Squeeze the overall, squeeze him and kill him. He died instantly. When he died, everyone began to cry. The news came back home. Everyone began to cry. Ladies and gentlemen, they brought the corpse to bury. After the burial, the old woman opened her mouth and said she was the one that killed him because he gave her a pa. He did not give her money to sew the cloth. Hear me, everyone. This year, no witch that will destroy you are confessed.
Amen.
Hear me, everyone. anyone about to use the spirit of witchcraft to tamper with your matter, to tamper with your calling, to tamper with your business, to tamper with your family, to tamper with your finance, to tamper with your husband, to tamper with your wife, to tamper with your health, to tamper with your family, to tamper with your future. Holy Ghost! They cannot pin you down with the spirit of witchcraft and begin to confess. I don't want that. Somebody shout
error.
I decree upon your life. Anyone that wants to use witchcraft to manipulate your life, to manipulate your life. Holy Ghost.
Fire.
Somebody shout fire 21 times.
Fire.
2.
Fire.
3.
Fire.
4.
Fire.
5.
Fire.
6.
Fire.
Louder.
Fire.
Louder.
Fire.
9.
Fire.
10.
Fire.
12.
Fire.
12.
Fire.
13.
Fire.
14.
Fire.
15.
Fire.
16.
Fire.
17.
Fire.
18.
Fire.
19.
Fire.
20.
Fire.
21.
Fire.
They will use witch to destroy the person's life, and at the end they will begin to confess. That's a big error. They can't destroy you. In fact, you are untouchable this year. 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 When they plan to come to you in your dream, the angel of God shall call them up. When they plan to come to you in the spirit, the angel of God shall call them up. Somebody shout, I believe to the time.
I believe.
Two.
I believe.
Three.
I believe.
Hear me, everyone. Are you here today? The word coming from the throne of grace is for you.
Amen.
The Bible says, no iota of my word that will ever go unfulfilled. Every prophetic word you are receiving now, they are going to germinate in your life.
Amen.
They are going to bear fruit in your lives.
Amen.
You hear me? You are not the same person you were as long as you attended the God of Solution.
Amen.
You are a different person from now.
Amen.
What stop others will not stop you this year.
Amen.
What made others to cry will not make you cry this year.
Amen.